It is the only one to take place inside the Arctic Circle, while the country's major tournament itself lasts just a week. Compare that to most major European leagues, which run over 9 months. Then there are the considerable geographical challenges Greenland faces in putting on football matches. The country is as big as Germany, France, Spain, Italy, Austria, Switzerland, and Belgium combined, but only 20% of the country is habitable. Moreover, 80% of the country is ice sheet, the second largest in the world following Antarctica. There is also no flat land, few suitable grass areas, and for 9 months of the year no football can be played outside, as the pitches are covered by nearly 2 meters of snow. The vast distances between cities and unpredictable weather conditions make travel at times near impossible, even in the summer, ensuring organizing games can be problematic. Read: How the Premier League embraced the world/strong broken bones. Yet, somehow, the beautiful game not only survives, it thrives. It's the country's most popular sport by some distance. There are currently 5,000 players in Greenland, that's 10% of the population. This year was the 47th year of the championships in its modern guise, but up until 2016, football in Greenland was played on pitches of sand and rock, which meant teams' physiotherapists were kept busy. It wasn't unusual for there to be several broken legs, noses, arms, and various other bones after each game. It was actually expected, and still people played. It was just basically a hard sand pitch, Johannes Groth, the captain of defending champions B67, told News Total Sport. Sometimes there were big rocks, so when you played hard it would hurt very much. It was really dusty, so we had to water the pitch just so we could control the ball, added B67 midfielder Patrick Fredriksson. It was difficult to play on, as you were never sure where the ball would land or bounce. The pitch was even worse for goalkeepers, said former G44 captain Johan Frederik Zeeb, who won the championship in 2013. In order to be a goalkeeper on those pitches, you really had to give your full self, he said. You had to have several layers of clothing to be a goalkeeper on dirt ground. You got a lot of scratches all over your body. Even today, many players choose to wear gloves and leggings to protect their bodies, a hangover from the dirt pitches they grew up on. Read: Photo of asylum seeker wins Barcelona award/strong bright future. 2 years ago, Greenland stepped up its efforts to become a recognized FIFA member and invested in several artificial turfs around the country. We have an agreement between the Danish Football Association and the Greenland Ball Games Union to develop football in Greenland, said Danish FA president Jesper Møller. It was our plan to build 6 full-sized artificial pitches by 2021, but there are already 11 or 12. It has been a great success. It's a long journey, but we've started it, added Møller. The future of Greenland football is bright. Read: Ronaldo banned for 5 games/strong Disco Island. This year's tournament was played in Kekkertarsuaq on Disco Island. It's an ancient volcanic island, now upgraded with a new artificial pitch sandwiched between red flat-top mountains, which the locals call the Grand Canyon, on one side and a beach of black sand on the other. If it's got the feeling of the land that time forgot, Greenland will always stand out for the brevity of its season. To qualify for one of the 8 spots in the week-long tournament, 40 teams from all over the country competed in regional qualifiers during July. Read: Female footballers break world record for highest ever football match/strong. The final took place between B67, from the capital city of Nuuk, who had won the tournament 6 out of the previous 7 years, and their city rivals IT79. It was a tense affair that threatened to be a rout at times, as B67 missed chance after chance, but their gung-ho tactics left them exposed at the back to IT79's counter-attacking football, and after extra time the score was tied at 2-2. Perry Fleischer was the man who made history, scoring the winning penalty to secure IT79's first ever title. "This is the club's first championship, and it means everything to us," IT79 captain Kasa Ngwek Zeeb told News Total. "Many of the players are crying. It's very emotional for us. The club only started up again in 2014 with only about 4 or 5 players. We had to train with our ladies team as we didn't have enough players to train on our own. We have built from the bottom and now we are the champions of Greenland. What's the most stunning view you've had at a football match? /strong Let us know on our Facebook page. IT79 founder Alan Geisler, who had to sail 18 hours to reach Disco Island, described their 2017 success as the biggest achievement in our history. B67 have been champions for many years, so I'm glad we beat them. It's incredible. There will be a huge party. With the tournament over, the players will now have to wait 10 months to be able to play outside again and a year for their next competitive fixture.